recognition of the Eastern Canadian Basketball League is to be a positive community partner and grow the game in and around the towns and cities we inhabit. In that spirit, we'd like to recognize the local organizations and programs who will be partnering with and benefiting with our 50-50 draw throughout the season. They will be taking the floor as I announce them, representing the Moncton Minor Basketball Association. Please welcome to Mayor Stephen.
Une énorme plaisir d'être parmi vous au nom du conseil municipal et tous les citoyennes et citoyens de Moncton. It is so great to be back here and to welcome professional men's basketball to our beautiful Avenir Center. C'est vraiment un plaisir d'accueillir à nouveau les baskets de ici au centre d'Avenir. Moncton is a basketball town. We have an incredible basketball community. And I would like to take this opportunity to welcome the players to our city. We are so happy to have you here. And to the fans, welcome back.
The Motion and the ECBL are thrilled to have aboard many sponsors and partners to make these games possible. Although there is a long list, we would like to extend special thanks to these few right now. League sponsors, Uni Financial, Rehab One, The United Way, Papa John's, and In Color. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our national anthem, and we would like to welcome, performing our national anthem tonight, Andrew Moore. And now, the words you've longed to hear, Moncton. Get on your feet for your 2023 Moncton Motion.
All right, basketball fans, welcome to the 2023 home season and franchise opener for the brand new Moncton Magic. Welcome to the Avenir Center. My name is Adam Gould, here with my colleague this evening, Dave Tingley. Dave will be joining us here in just a few moments. Thank you for tuning in tonight. We're really excited to be having the pro basketball back in the greater Moncton area. Couldn't be more thrilled to be back here at the Avenir Center. You just caught Andrew Moore with our national anthem. Some electric guitar to get things started. We got Andrew here now. Andrew, how do you feel that went, man? Thank you so much for coming out and performing the anthem. We really appreciate it. A lot of fans have gotten some really good feedback to me so far. How do you feel that went for you?
Oh, man, it was awesome. Thank you very much for having me. Great pleasure. We got a great sound system in here. It sounds awesome, and it's just a pleasure to play in the new arena. This is my hometown, so...
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Yeah, thank you for coming out. It's a great opportunity to expose some local talent to the Moncton fans. You're a great musician. You deserve this opportunity and this platform. You killed it, and thank you so much for coming out tonight.
Thank you very much. I appreciate your support.
Absolutely. If you haven't heard of Andrew Moore, folks, make sure to check him out on social media. He just released a new record called The Dip Session, available on YouTube. You can record the entire session by checking it out on YouTube. We'll be back in a few minutes with our starting lineups right here at the Moncton Avenir Center.
Yeah.
As we get ready to sound the buzzer, we're now kicking off the 2023 season here at the Avenir Center for the brand new ECBL, the East Coast Eastern Canadian Basketball League, rather. Adam Gould here with my broadcast partner, Dave Tingley.
Dave, right, Adam, now we get to do the fun stuff, man.
Oh, man.
Fun stuff.
We're finally able to do what we want to do. We'll go to Taya Bailey here.
Program. Please welcome Jackson Amos, Dallas Amos, Austin Amos, Holden Carpenter, Hudson Warren, and Michael Marsh. And now, a 6'5" small forward from San Fernando, California, Robbie Robinson. A 6'6" forward from Los Angeles, California, Andre Frazier. A 6'4" guard from Baltimore, Maryland, Tristan Davis. 6-foot guard from Herkill, Oklahoma, Kendall Purbaugh. A 7-foot center from Ottawa, Ontario, Emmanuel Nedjarin. A 6'9 forward from Lorna Linda, California, Debbie Chapani. A 6'2 guard, Jeff Montenegro. A 6-foot guard from Jacksonville, Florida, Janelle Jenkins. And a 6'2 guard from Halifax, but we call him a Monctonian, Mark McLaughlin. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, welcome from your city of Moncton, at 6'5" forward, James French. Your head coach is Todd McKillop. Now we will meet the starting lineups. First for Bathurst, wearing number 4, Giovanni Jackson. Number 7, Andrew Ferguson Holmes. Number 10, Stanley Mayumbo. Number 15, O.J. Watson, and number 21, Bruce Yetemin. And now your starters for your Moncton Motion, wearing number 30, Janelle Jenkins. Wearing number 5, Robbie Robinson. Coming in at number 10, W.A. Chabini. Wearing number 13, Tristan Davis. And number 19, Jeff Montenegro. We have a ceremonial tip tonight, guys, so let's start this. Fans, the Moncton Motion and the ECBL are privileged to welcome to center court for our ceremonial tip time, Krista Richard. Back in her competitive days, Krista was tenacious on the softball field, competing provincially, nationally, and internationally. But with her combination of dynamism, determination, and a fierce love for her community and its kids, she was destined to make a mark on the Hub City as an educator and organizer. For years, she has improved the lives of youth and families in Greater Moncton in the classroom and through programs such as Kids in Action and Bikes and Trikes. Now it's her community sports program through which she's continuing her legacy of giving back. And her support of the game of basketball is unsurpassed as well. No surprise that she was the very first person to place her Moncton Motion ticket order. Please rise to your feet and put your hands together for Krista Richard and her community sports program and her guests, Mohammed Khalid, Omar Nafal, and Abdel Nafal.
All right, basketball fans, once again, welcome to the Moncton Avenir Center, where tonight, the home season and franchise opener for the Moncton Motion, and we're off.
All right, man, so this is going to be an interesting matchup. We got the 0-2 Bathurst Bears coming in a little bit seasoned. They've played a little bit together, and you've got a brand new Moncton Motion team facing opposition for the first time there, Adam. But one thing, and with ceremonial and historical first hoop from Janiel Jenkins starting thing off for the motion.
The very first Janiel basket Jenkins. In franchise history. And we do have an awesome basketball community here in the greater Moncton area. Nice to see the fans showing up for that one.
Right back at it.
Stanley 2 points. Players. Stanley Mabayo. Yeah. Mayumbo, pardon me.
Stanley Mayumbo, the New Brunswick content for the Bears in the starting lineup. And a nice move by Montenegro inside.
Good in the paint.
Jeff Montenegro.
One thing that the Motion have is an abundance of guys in the backcourt. You can put the ball on the deck and create for themselves. Adam, we've seen that. There's not a lot of... They don't have an overabundance of size right now, but they got Jenkins.
Steals it. And 4-point lead for Moncton, 6-2 early.
Janiel, the late arrival. Spent a night overnight in the airport only a few nights ago, getting here from Jacksonville, Florida, his hometown, and showing out early is Mr. Jenkins. 4 points already.
Tim Mitchell makes a move in the paint.
And that's a name that Moncton fans are going to recognize. Adam, I know you did.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Moncton in transition. Nice pump fake.
Robbie Robinson.
Double R.
Another familiar name for Moncton Motion fans from
here we go,
the old
Motion
days
fans.
In
defense.
The
Coliseum,
in
I
the
believe.
NBLC, defense. Yeah. He played for the Island Storm and dig it in.
Moncton out to a quick 6-point lead. Moncton 8, Bathurst 2.
And Tristan Davis there on the defense. And Tristan,
one more time.
Another
defense.
Guy, strong, fell in the backcourt. A lot defense. Of these guys for the Motion you're going to see defense. Are between about 6 feet, 6'5", somewhere in there for these guys. Not a lot of huge size yet for the Motion, as with all of these. And a nice, nicely defended inside, always going to go up for two.
I thought that was going to be too many steps, but looks like
Robbie Robinson
picks up his first.
Yeah, unsure about that one, Adam, I'll be honest. Looked like it was pretty clean from here. My first questioning of a referee call.
I'm surprised.
Of the new league. I'm
surprised it took almost 5 minutes.
I love our refs. You know what, Adam? The great thing about the refs is they're as bought in to the future of this franchise and this league as anyone else is. The refs, you know, doing such a terrific job. You know, rolling with everything just like everybody else's brand new league. They know, you know, they got their brand spanking new ECBL unis that they're proud of, and they got but they're as bought in, just their community, part of this community just like everybody else, these referees. It's Robbie Robinson pops the three and misses.
Absolutely. And you know, when it comes to the referees, I mean, a lot of people had some comments for us last year, the magic with our, you know, criticism of the refs, but it's very important that the fans understand we're not criticizing. We're both basketball players, Dave and I.
Yeah.
And we love the sport. We're passionate about it. And, you know, we do have an opinion. And, you know, the referees, I definitely would not want to be a referee in any sport.
It's the most, we've said it before many times on broadcast, Adam, it is the most difficult sport to referee. And it's not even close. Block charge is the single most difficult call in all of sports. And, when we criticize a call, we don't get personal with these fellas. We know how hard it is.
And thankfully, we're not in the NBA.
Oh, and turn
beautiful
the corner
move.
And finish in. It's Giovanni Jackson.
Nice take to the hoop.
Jackson.
Cuts the lead to five.
Squeezes in for two. And that, lead down to three now. Davier Champagny.
Oh, my calculator was broken there. Sorry about that. 8-5. Just because you see the number five doesn't mean you say the number five. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mambo number five.
That's broadcasting number one. That's lesson number one for
man.
For you tonight,
apparently.
Adam, on the broadcast mic.
That's
don't
right.
Don't say things that you see in your field of view.
And they just crop up in the old brain there. You got to put that filter on.
Robinson on the pull up.
Nice take. That was a Lou Bega reference, Mambo number five, folks.
Yeah.
Don't make me sing it.
You're all about the old school. And look at first impressions of Janiel Jenkins, Adam.
He's all over the place. Great tenacity. Half-court pickup is awesome on the defensive 30, end. Jenkins, great attack on the basketball.
Yeah, a little bit of defense out of Janiel.
Yeah, just a bit.
So far, And he's, difficult for a guy coming in off a plane 3 days ago after spending a night in an airport and just going, just walking in the building. He's shook my hand. He's got a big smile, does Janiel. He's absolutely super engaging, super nice guy. Just like all these guys, I've been telling everybody all week, these are great human beings looking to build a brand new league in all these cities. And I can't wait for fans to get out and meet these guys and see what they're about off the floor just as much as on.
We've had a couple community events, let's say. We had a meet and greet at the Sports Rock this week, really well attended. I know you were at the East End Boys and Girls Club with the guys as well, Dave.
They were amazing. I had to rip them out of there to get them to practice.
That's great.
Yeah. Robinson with the block. Tim Mitchell on the block on Robinson. The old Moncton Miracles player. And then Mitchell and Robinson, old foes from that league, getting back into it.
Really high level of play. Really physical play as well here. Looks like the boys are getting fired up.
The boys are mixing it up a little bit. Now Robinson and Mitchell getting back together and working things out.
We've got some words right here. Let's hope that this can be resolved easily.
I don't think they're working it out.
No.
I don't think they're working it out, Adam.
It was a bit hostile when I saw the physical contact, but, you know, it could have just been a bump.
Yeah.
You know, not looking the right way.
No.
Things happen.
Yeah, but Timmy's got a big smile on his face. He was one of the fan favorites back with the Miracles.
Yep.
And I know you were a fan of his. When he walked in, he gave me a big bear hug.
That's his first.
Absolutely. He was my favorite player on the 1 year I was on the mic for the Miracles back in the day. But, you know, coming back to New Brunswick for the brand new league and loving life.
Nice take by Davier Champagne. Is it Champagne? I think it's Champagne. We're going to go with Champagne for tonight.
No. That's Davier Champagne, and that is for the motion.
You're looking at Champagne.
See, again, early jitters, man.
No,
you got to look at the right roster.
Foul. No, he just
said the foul on him. Oh, excuse me.
Come on, Dave.
My bad.
How many jobs you doing?
Why did I question you?
I don't know.
Yeah, Davier on the foul, but to the line for two free throws. And again, is Mayambo, a Fredericton High guy. Now he's playing for Coach Serge Langis in Bathurst. We haven't talked about Serge yet. Also an old
great coach.
Acquaintance of ours.
One of my former coaches, actually.
And one of my best friends in the world.
University of Moncton.
Yeah.
Was fortunate to play under Serge the first year they brought the program back in 2000.
Yep. On the pull-up, Robbie. Now he's getting
Robbie
into it.
Double R Robinson for two.
That guy works as hard on his shooting routine as anybody I've ever seen. Look at Stanley. My goodness. The New Brunswicker taking things over for the Bears. Getting all the way to the hole. A little discussion going on with the refs. Unbelievably, Adam, the unblemished record of fans of referees not overturning their calls continues into year 100 and blah, 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 blah.
Hey, at least they're consistent with it, I guess, right?
They are, no.
But how about the crowd here tonight?
Listen, dude.
For the first game, I mean, it's a new league, it's a new team, a lot of new teams happening at the same time. Yep. It's difficult to pull this thing together, as we both know. But we're here, we made it, we're smiling, we're laughing, I'm actually really excited.
Yep.
But look at the friggin' people in the crowd.
Yeah, it's a big crowd.
The attendance is awesome. I think that's a really great testament to the basketball community in Moncton. So shout out to all the fans that came out and all the ones that are planning on attending a game later this season.
Yeah, absolutely. Check out our Facebook page there, fans. You get the link tree to everything. It's a nice little drop off. Montenegro.
Tristan
Jeff
Davis.
Drops it to Tristan Davis for two and his first points.
Moncton's off to a 12-7 lead.
Champagne out top on the D, and he digs down, comes away with it.
Robbie Robinson stuffed by the rim, gets his own rebound.
Double R.
Back to Janiel Jenkins, and
and Robbie, he's going to hang his head on that one. Little smile for the bench.
Boys are playing with a lot of pressure right now. They're fired up. They want to get out of the gate quick.
A lot of miles on Robbie's legs. Not so many miles he can't get up and hammer down anymore. He was doing it in warm-up with ease.
Yeah.
A little mistiming there from Robbie. And new one of the floor, Eman. Emmanuel Ndachue.
Looks like we'll have a holding foul.
Yeah.
On number 23, Shaquille. I apologize for this, Shaquille. It's handwritten.
Gilgeous Glasgow.
It's handwritten. So is Shaquille Gilgeous Glasgow?
Yeah.
Like Gilgeous Alexander.
There you go.
Awesome NBA player, Shea. Gilgeous Alexander, that is.
So Robbie in the corner. He's had a tough time getting going. Instantly, he's instantly one of the best offensive players in this league. Just gotten off to a little bit of a rough start from distance so far. But he earns a little turnover there.
Very active.
Back to the motion.
Very active.
Yeah, Robbie's really involved in this league. He's got a lot invested in it. He's marketing with the league as well as playing. You know, he's got a lot invested in this league. He believes in it strongly, and he is on top of that. He's got range from there, but no. Comes up short. Josiah Moore handling things, gets it to Mayambo. Mabel's got a pop, and he's got it going to Stanley.
Cuts the lead to 3-12-9. Moncton's up in the first quarter.
It was three. That's a two-point game. That was from distance for Stanley. He's been most of the offense for the Bears so far. There goes Montenegro. And the follow-up. Your first what, Adam? Your first and one. Firsts all over the place.
Wow. How was the journey to get to this moment, Dave? It's been an interesting ride, hasn't it?
Do you think?
Dave wears a lot of hats with this team. I don't know your official title, but I know you're basically acting.
Manager of Business Basketball Operations.
Which means you're handling a million things.
Yes.
Thank you for asking me to come back onto the broadcast this year. I'm really pleased to be back with the team. And I do want to give a special shout-out. Fans on the broadcast won't be able to see, but to my immediate left, our official DJ for the season, DJ Marcoshi. And I want to say thank you to Andrew Moore, who performed our national anthem on the electric guitar.
That was gorgeous.
This evening. You like that?
That was gorgeous. Awesome. You did good work. And I got to thank you, man. Without you, this broadcast wouldn't be possible and this day wouldn't be possible. Your work is much appreciated. And three more from the corner. This time.
O.J. Watson.
That was O.J. Watson, my man. O.J. Watson for three. O.J. with his first points tonight. Back door goes Robbie. He's not going to miss that one.
Robbie shakes
his head a little bit. That flush wasn't a miss. And Kendall Prapal onto the floor now for the motion as well. Joining in Datue off the bench. Oh, another nice take. Can't pops out. And Prapal on the rebound. Two on one now. Oh, and a rejection inside on Ndachue. An injection again on Prapal.
Josiah Moore with a beautiful block. Bathurst coming on the other side. And Moncton foul going to the line.
Yeah, Robbie Robinson's going to get whistled for the foul on that one. Taking it hard to the hole.
And Shaquille Gilgis, Glasgow, will be going to the line for two.
Five, Robbie Robinson.
Love that name.
That's
and we're going to go to
personal
a
foul.
Media timeout, I think, our first. Yeah, media timeout of the season, fans.
We have a media timeout.
So we'll mention a couple of the big sponsors we mentioned off the top, Adam, the guys that we couldn't have done this day about. And I know you worked very closely with one of them, but we can't go any further without thanking Uni. Uni's support of this league and these two teams couldn't have done this without Uni Financial. So shout out to them. But I know you were deeply involved with a local business getting a little logo on our center court there, Mr. Gould.
Yeah, our center court logo was graciously donated by Bernie and his amazing team at In Color Printing. They're one of the oldest print companies in the city. For all your printing needs, make sure to check out In Color on Horseman Road in Moncton. And so thank you very much, Bernie, and we appreciate you getting that work done for us so we could have that logo at center court.
Yeah, and the ECBL, the great thing about this is all the sponsors, if they're sponsoring one team, they sponsor the league. So all these sponsors are league sponsors. And the ECBL, so from across the Maritimes, the ECBL wants to thank all these sponsors that we mentioned. And speaking of one that just walked in front of us.
The very attractive John Gonzalez.
You had to throw that in, did you? You had to throw in the attractiveness?
He's just so cool, man. I just wish I was a bit more like John, but here I am.
Everybody wishes they were more like Johnny G.
He's wearing like a black cutoff, and I'm just wearing his purple shirt.
Yeah, today's so Rehab 1, they've been long been a program. Friend of basketball in the Moncton area, and they're back with the Moncton Motion and the ECBL. And thanks to Johnny G, too, and I know Charlottetown, Gail McDonald, I hope you're listening over there in Charlottetown. I know he helped streamline a trainer over there too. He really helped the Charlottetown Power get their therapist in place, having some connections. So Johnny G, more than just helping, again, in the spirit of the league, not just reaching out and helping our team here in this city, he's helping all the teams. So yeah. Thanks to Johnny G for what he does for the motion and how he helped us out league wide.
Yeah, great brand that he has and great company. I'm a client of theirs with some physio and some massage therapy. They've got a full range of services. Make sure to check them out. Rehab 1, thank you so much.
Yeah, you can't do this without these guys. You can't run a league like this
No.
without the proper therapy, and those guys are amazing.
And we also can't do that
without the help of our sponsors. So if you're out there interested in getting involved and becoming a sponsor of this league or this great broadcast, please do reach out to us at david.tingley, which is T-I-N-G-L-E-Y, at ecbl.ca. We are going to be looking for sponsors for the broadcast and other areas. So we will be going out in the next week or so and checking in with the business community to see who's involved in getting who's interested in getting involved, rather. So make sure to let us know if you want to get involved with the team, and otherwise we'll be on our way out to see you very shortly.
A little pressure there from the Bears, and Montenegro breaks it with ease, but then
turns it over.
And almost a turnover right back, but no, laying it in at the other end.
Giovanni Jackson.
Giovanni Jackson with his second hoop.
Great effort by Janelle Jenkins to try to save that one, just short.
Oh, nice spin inside by E-Man. It's a little pressure here from the Bears, trying to speed up the motion a little bit. Bears coming in, like we talked about, Adam 0-2. They've lost their first two on the,
that's his first
on the new season, but they're sticking with the motion here early. Motion threatened to run away a little bit, a little run, but... And you see that shooting stroke from a big guy.
Yeah, it's pretty smooth.
Right? Love watching E-Man work on his shot in practice. Consistent from the three-point line and from the free throw line. So gonna be a weapon for the motion this year. As Jackson breaks the pressure.
Just under 5 minutes to go. Moncton is up 19-17.
Montenegro creating some havoc.
Ooh. Nice move, Montenegro with 2 points.
Got that solid just body, Adam, and that backcourt.
Strong,
big shoulders.
Guard. Yeah,
just and backed his man in on a fast break for a lay-in.
Yeah, it's that bully post up.
Absolutely. 4-point lead. Now Jackson working that screen and roll. Brandon Jamar can't chase it down.
Another nice effort from Jenkins.
Absolutely. He's everywhere. Quick feet, quick hands. Creighton. Turnovers, the defensive end, new possessions offensively, and there you see that stroke. Oh, in and out for E-Man.
Big man with a three-point attempt, no good. Bathurst the other way, three-point attempt of their own.
Rammed out, but the follow there.
And the put back from Jamar, good for two, cuts it to a two-point Moncton lead.
Yeah, Jamar hasn't made his name known much in this first quarter, the big man, but
making his presence felt.
Gets his name on the score sheet there. You see this, if you're a fan of Crandall basketball, you're familiar with this offensive ball movement. Yeah, you can't hang that far back on E-Man. But he missed the jumper, and back the other way come the Bears, and it's Miambo again. And a shot from distance for three, rims out. From Watson, back come the other way, pushing that pace. Oh, look at the blow by. And
good
the
for
finish.
Two.
Gorgeous from Tristan Davis.
You're so amazing, Dave.
As Adam.
Snapping a dual selfies
for
us.
Art, getting some art of us in there in our first broadcast here.
Oh, man, I'm so excited to be here right now.
It's going to be a lot of fun. Good close out there for me, man.
We got 13 home games here, Moncton fans, so 12 remaining after this one. It'll be another couple weeks, though, before we get to our second date.
It's
going to be
2 weeks
from tonight
until
we play game two. Checking in for the motion. Moncton native. Born in Halifax, but Moncton native Mark McLaughlin. His wife plays for the Mystics.
Nice.
The women's professional team here in town, Kelsey. And I'm sure she's proud to watch Mark out there on the floor. Not hands down the best player in the Maritimes, his age. And as with any league and new startup league, any league around the world, early in a season, as Robbie Robinson misses another jumper there, and he's yet to get off the schneid just yet, is Robbie. But as with anything, the rosters are late developing sometimes, right? Like these guys come into town late. You add guys to your roster late. It happens in these leagues. These leagues all over the world, and it's no different in our league. There he is again. Janiel.
Another poke from Jenkins. And the Jets on the other side. What a move. Janiel Jenkins to the rock.
Oh, the coast to coast. And the first play, I think they really brought the fans to their feet tonight, Adam.
And the other way. Boy. Quiet that crowd pretty quick. Tim Mitchell.
Nice play, though.
Throwing
Tim
it down.
Mitchell. Familiar sight for the Moncton Hoops fans with a flush for Mr. Mitchell. But as I was saying, Adam, good when you have quality players and individuals, as Papal not able to finish, but when you have quality individuals and players like McLaughlin in your city that you can lean on to fill a roster spot, and And it's not, he's not just filler. He's not just roster filler. You're going to see the man can play hoops.
Nice.
E-Man looking for a handoff. There's Robbie Robinson. Here comes Janiel. Looking for the screen and a pull-up from three.
Some nice height on that jump shot.
Oh, yeah. He's got a pretty jumper. Tall and soft, but rebounded there by Josiah Moore.
Ooh, that sounded like it hurt. Hopefully he's going to be okay.
Yeah, that sounded like
a nice, clean block, but he got the body.
Yeah, definitely a little body there.
Fouls on Moncton number 21, Emmanuel
Natchez. Yeah, it's going to be Emmanuel Natchez, and he's favoring his hip a little bit there. Maybe. He might have taken a little shot. But 25-21 with 1:35 on the clock. Shout out to our friend John Richard.
What's up, John? Fighter Jet, right? Studios.
Fighter Jet.
The guy's amazing.
Hello. Have you seen our score clock in the building?
The graphics, all the moving graphics. John, you're an absolute creative beast. We appreciate you so much for helping us get all of our visuals together for our home opener. And we look forward to working with you again this season. And if you have any needs for creative work, especially when it comes to AV, make sure to look up Fighter Jet Studios, John Richard, one of the best.
Oh, yeah, and one of the people without which tonight we just wouldn't be possible. So,
and let me correct myself. It's not just AV. He does a little bit of AV, a lot of graphic design, a lot of, you know, full motion video type stuff too, yes. Animation. So he's a jack of all trades, does a lot of great stuff.
Oh, nice move, and there's McLaughlin!
Boy, gets first basket. McLaughlin! Moncton motion player.
Lovely offense there from the motion, and if you recognize it, fans, you might have watched. Oh, that's going to be a second on Jenkins.
Good effort, but still moving the feet.
Tenacious. But if you recognize the offensive sets and the motion offense,
that's his second.
Pardon me, that the motion of running, you'll recognize it from being probably a Crandall fan because Todd McKillop runs the same sets for Crandall.
People still play the flex these days.
Yeah, you still see that.
Yeah, every once in a while.
But it's more the principles of the flex.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Flex cuts. They don't run that exact, you know. But you'll see some, especially there's some college teams in the States, they run that. It's basically just a term for a tight offense with a lot of screens, right?
Right, yeah.
So it's, you know, but things are so spaced nowadays in basketball, right?
Mm-hmm.
And these two teams show it. Things are so spaced out. Everybody needs to be able to handle the ball. Everybody needs to be able to shoot the ball a little bit.
Great pace to tonight's game. We got 1 minute left to play in the first quarter.
Kendall Purpal turns the corner, not able to finish, and then Ndachue follows up twice, and he's going to go to the line.
Ndachue is a nice presence down below. Like you said, nice shooting stroke for a big guy, too.
Fouls big boy went to UPEI.
Seven, Andrew Ferguson Holmes, that's his first personal foul.
I believe the youngest guy on the team. He's recently,
oh, wow.
Recently out of school. Him and James French would be around the same age.
Ndachue.
Yes.
Thank you for helping me with the phonetics on that.
Yeah, man. I'm here. I'm here for you.
Hooked on phonics. Work for me, man.
Ndachue. So nice to see McLaughlin come off the bench and get a little lay-in. I bet you his wife and kids watching as E-Man goes 2 for 2, and the lead is out to 29-25 here for the motion. As we approach the end of this first quarter, runner there, rebounded by Ndachue. He's had a terrific first quarter, Adam.
Absolutely. He's been all over the place. Boards,
nice
scoring. Oh.
Robinson just can't get it going.
Maybe it's the first game jitters.
He's not a jittery guy. When that lid comes off, you watch.
And a big triple from the corner.
Yeah, the lid came off there.
Giovanni Jackson.
Yeah, Jackson had himself a pretty good first quarter. Got into the paint a little bit. That one showed his versatility. Shooting from the perimeter.
As we come to the close of the first quarter here,
Bathurst's chance to take the lead here, going to the break.
Beautiful
nice
block from the Dodgeway to close off. At the end of the first quarter, Moncton Motion 29, the Bathurst Bears 28, and we got some more physical contact on the floor here. Hopefully everything can just cool itself off and all the players can continue to play in the second half.
Absolutely. Tim Mitchell in the middle of it again.
Looks like the referees are going to be lenient on this one. So we got our very first quarter of basketball in the history books for the Moncton Motion. Thoughts on the first quarter, Dave?
It was fun to watch, Adam, back and forth. Guys still getting their feet underneath them. I mean, some of these guys, like we say, have only been in town for a few days. You know, and this is, but you know, you're going to see some, it's going to take some time for these guys to gel a little bit, right?
Yeah.
I mean, they've been playing 5-on-5, I mean, barely, right, for the last few days.
Right.
You know, but the one, actually, I shouldn't say that because the coach, Coach McKillop's been able to lean on his guys from Crandall. And a special shout out to a couple guys there, Devon Glenn, Tyree Cooper. Colby McIntosh, I saw him in there. I'm gonna forget a couple guys and feel like a jerk, but
friggin' jerk.
I know, right? But especially Devon Glenn, he was giddy almost. He wanted to go to. He said, "Dave, I got to go to class, but I heard a ball bouncing in here, and it was like a kind of like a siren song for him." So he came to the gym. He ran a little because they run similar sets because you know college pro they pretty much run the same stuff. You know, it's all the same principles. So he was helping the guys get some shots up. Davier Champagny had a sweat on, a full sweat on from Devon Glenn, helping him run through shooting drills. So it's already impacted some of these players, this pro team being in town. It's already impacted some of these players. Some of those guys were absolutely giddy. And some of them got out and ran in practice. Ethan Culbertson, I want to shout him out. I saw him in a couple of Ethan there. So these guys have been running with the guys too, helping them fill out the practice squad and helping fill out the drills and make sure they got 5-on-5 and they can run their stuff even when guys were still flying in. So it's been a real team effort from the basketball community in Moncton to get this team ready. And they 29 on the board in the first quarter, Adam. That's pretty high scoring quarter.
I'm pretty happy with the first quarter overall as a basketball fan. Everything that you would want: action, pace, aggressiveness on the ball, defense,
and you can see the passion. I mean, the guys, you know, a little pushing and shoving. I mean, you don't want that to continue too much. You want to stomp that out if you can. But I mean, it shows the passion these guys have for playing the sport that they love.
And every coach wants their players to be aggressive and hungry. Of course, they don't want any physical altercations, but that physicality is critical to demonstrate, you know, your dominance over the other team, that you really want to, you know, get ahead.
McLaughlin's going to have an open three.
Beautiful. The Moncton native,
Mark
5 points
McLaughlin
on the board.
McLaughlin for three. Mark from deep, making his mark.
It looks like they're going to looks like they're going to double team Robbie Robinson here. I think they frustrated him a little bit in the first quarter, and they picked up on that. And first touch of the ball, he got a double team. Oh, so let's see what the rest of it looks like.
What defense there by E-Man. And Papal. KP in for two.
Quick 4 points for Moncton to open up the second quarter.
But you can see, I think Mitchell's a little frustrated at this point, Adam. So he decided in that moment, I'm going to be a bull in a china shop and get my way to the hoop, even though it wasn't the prudent play. And E-Man just stood his ground. Yeah. Excellent work from Ndachue.
Beautiful defense tonight from Ndachue and also on the offensive end. But that time gets blown by.
Yeah, that was Gilgis. Glasgow squeezing inside. That was a difficult finish around the long arms of E-Man. So nicely done by him. Little two-man game here. Likes his matchup in the post is Tristan on Andrew Holmes.
The Bears double-team him as well.
Yeah, Mitchell came over with the help, and Andrew Holmes is going to be a name that's familiar to fans of Moncton Hoops. These guys have seen Andrew Holmes on some teams in the previous leagues and stuff, so good to see Andrew, a Maritime native, still playing some hoops.
Speaking of hoops, man, I can't wait for the snow to continue to melt and get out and start playing some hoop ball in these courts around Greater Moncton.
Right? Oh, and that's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. Robbie didn't get a communication from his team. That's the kind of thing you got to hear it from the bench a little bit, Adam. You got to rely on your bench to count you down if you've only got a couple seconds left.
We give a big shout-out to our official photographer this year, Tanya Everett. One of the staples here in this community. She's been doing it for as long as I can remember doing events, always willing to step up to the plate and help out, and we're very proud to have Tanya Everett Photography this year as our official photographer, rather, so thank you, Tanya.
She's just unselfish. Does anything you ask.
Tim Mitchell draws the foul.
He does. He
big boy.
Yeah, he is, and he was physical in a smart way.
Yeah.
That time, Adam, he put the ball on the deck, got himself into a position where he got Davier off balance a little bit. Wasn't able to take it on the numbers. Be a charge, so up and in for two. For the first one is Timmy, but Adam, again, I don't know if I did it properly enough, so I'm going to do it now. I can't thank you enough for the work you've done to make this broadcast possible and this day possible for us here in Moncton.
Thank you, brother.
I'm pumping your tires, too.
I appreciate it, man.
So
team effort, but I do appreciate the mention, man. Thank you very much.
Yeah, so this community and the basketball community owe you a lot. And I'm going to make sure everybody knows about it.
You're too good to me, man. Thank you. But I'm grateful to have you in the mix. And to be honest, man, if it wasn't for you, I'm not sure if I would have been able to pull all this off. So grateful to be on the team. Happy that I was able to contribute to the game today. And looking forward to a successful season, first season here for the Moncton Motion.
The Bears stuck two here now. It's a little screen and roll action. Mitchell wanted the three, didn't take it.
Nice hero step. Beauty. Blocked.
Beauty there from Champagne. Champagne. And the take.
All the way on the other side. Tristan Davis.
Tristan. Love his energy. Love his passion. I just really enjoyed being around Tristan since he came into town. He was one of the first guys that came in. He just put his head down and worked.
And just keep an eye on number 32 for Bathurst. Tim Mitchell. He's got an injury in his shoulder. He keeps grabbing at it and wincing. I think
might
he's in some pain here, yeah.
Oh, yeah, you're right. He's looked like his neck maybe even, too. He's kind of pinching it and rubbing it.
Yeah, he got...
It's going to be three, I think, on Janiel.
And quick scoring update, 36-32. Moncton's up by four. 8:58, just under 9 minutes left to play in quarter number two. The inbound... Shaquille Glasgow.
Fans, don't forget to visit the United Way table and get your 50-50 tickets tonight.
Screen from Mitchell.
Mayumbo with the take, kicks it over.
Yeah, that's just good offense against the clock. And they deserved it.
At the buzzer.
They deserved it.
Bathurst cut the lead to one.
That one was paid off, and that was Josiah Moore from deep. And Bathurst deserved that one. Lovely ball movement, patient against the clock. And Champagne looking for a handoff. Oh, nice kick.
Cross court. Doesn't go for Moncton.
And that was Tristan Davis. And he's been working like a maniac with Robbie Robinson and his shooting drills, which is nice, absolutely maniacal.
Yeah, looking forward to coming in and checking out a practice.
Oh, nice setup again. Oh, no. Long was McLaughlin, but he followed his own board.
Tristan Davis with a try in the opposite corner.
Motion ball.
That's going to be motion ball as Mitchell wasn't able to corral it and return it for the Bears.
And you can tell Mitchell's in some pain on that last board. He was only able to lift up his right arm to grab it. So I think he's got an injury here. It might prevent him from playing his best basketball today.
And Jamar is coming back in for him. And returning also is O.J. Watson for the Bears.
On the bench for Bathurst, you might recognize him, Cordell Jonte, former Moncton Miracles and Magic player. Just Miracles. I think he was a Miracles player.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if he played with the Magic.
I think he did, actually.
Did he? Yes. I was in Vancouver during those years.
I think
years.
He did, actually.
Here we go, Robinson, pardon me.
Yeah, good. That was really good vertical defense there inside.
Motion ball.
From Brandon Jamar. Bellied right up on him. And Robinson was not able to finish through the contact. So 36-35 here, 7.5 left in our first half, Adam.
Another big shout-out going out to Taya Bailey, also known as 180, ECMA-winning, Music New Brunswick Award-winning MC. But he's also our PA announcer here, helping out quite a bit. The three of us, I think we got a really awesome team here this year, and I just want to say shout-out to Taya for everything that you do, including being the voice in the arena here for the Moncton Magic and now Moncton Motion.
Absolutely. Oh, nice give. Jamar on the finish.
Nice cut to the basket.
Brandon Jamar.
That was pretty stuff there from Gilgis Glasgow, leaving it for him.
And, of course, as the season progresses, we'll be a lot more familiar with the pronunciation of some of these names. So thanks to everybody for their patience. Beautiful take.
Yeah, we were doing a lot of work before the game. I was hoping to get with these guys, and we hate. It's part of our pet peeve is not being able to, you know, to get with these guys before the game, look them in the face, and go, okay, man, here's how we're pronouncing your name. We got this right.
So what? You don't want me to call you David Tangley?
No.
Okay.
You cannot do that.
Okay.
You cannot do that.
Okay.
McLaughlin off with the first. He's got a second one coming up. 1-point deficit here now facing the Motion.
It's just under 7 minutes to play. Bathurst has taken the lead, but now tied at 37.
And checking out is McLaughlin as Davis returns. And the motion here matching up.
Pretty competitive game here today. Bathurst has something to prove. They don't want to go 0-3 to start the season.
Yeah, and Coach Landry's returning to Moncton. He wants to show out here. And, of course, for, you know, bragging rights and every other rights, we want Serge to go home with a loss.
Yeah,
but
we want this big W today.
And from deep there on the miss was Holmes. But active inside is Jamar, keeping things alive.
Every Moncton motion player is crashing the boards and trying to get that rebound, really frustrating the bigs on the Bathurst side tonight.
Kenny playing with his food there a little bit, trying to kick it out.
Motion but H.O. breakfast.
But Davier, a skilled big guy. He can make that shot from the wing. He was the one that really got a sweat on with Devon Glenn of Crandall earlier in the week. They can't leave Robbie open. I know he's missed him. Yeah.
There we go. Robbie
can't
Robbie.
Leave it. It's a hand down, man down situation for Robbie. Sooner or later, that hoop is going to open up, and it did for him on that one. Three and a three-point lead for the motion.
I just got a text from somebody saying that they didn't really know where the stream was, so we're going to share another link on the Moncton Motion page, and I'll share it to my own personal page as well.
Yeah, for
the
sure. Stream.
So we'll, again, our first game, we're working out a few of the kinks, and we will make sure to post that ahead of the game, so thanks for tuning
yeah,
in.
Yeah, we posted a little bit ahead of the game, fans. We're
number 15.
So it's OJ, you find the Moncton Motion Facebook page, you'll find the link to the live stream. It you know, put it up a little bit before the game, so I know fans are asking. You know what the deal with the live streams are. They got a lot of questions. So if you got questions, we got answers. We're willing to, like you said, you gave out my email address before. You're free to contact me there about anything. Contact us at the Facebook page. Contact us on our Instagram. We got Instagram. You contact us on Twitter. You contact us on TikTok. We're gonna be everywhere, fans. We got a really good social media guy. Shout out to Kyle Lyons.
Oh yeah.
How amazing has Kyle been for us?
I want to take a moment and thank some of our sponsors.
Kyle's been absolutely incredible. Social media marketing is very important, and it's not something that's enjoyable to a person like me, but necessary, almost critical. And Kyle's been a godsend, helping out with not only posting about what's happening, but taking videos and photography and really just interacting with everyone. He's a ball of energy. We love his enthusiasm, and we appreciate his contribution to the team. Yeah, Kyle, thank you very much, man. It feels like the old days. You know, a lot of the crew, especially from the scores table, I'm pretty sure it's everybody from the last time that we played together. I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it really is.
Especially Judy.
Yep.
The anchor in all of this. Shout out to Judy Vautour.
Yeah. Shout out to, yeah, I mean, this is a set it and forget it situation. You give Judy, you make her in charge of the scores table. And
yeah, it's taken care of.
And it's done. It's done. There's nothing else you need to do.
And also a big thank you to all of our volunteers for helping us make today a great success. And, Mayor Don Arnold for getting us started. It was a really difficult task to get this all pulled together and executed today. A lot of people here are very tired. A lot of people worked really hard to make this happen, and I want to say a big thank you to each and every person who put any energy, time, effort into making this launch as big of a success as it was.
And just before I hand things, I'm going to hand the reins over for my mic temporarily to Mr. Kendrick for you to give him some
sounds good.
Give him some questions. Before I do, I'm going to give a shout out to some sponsors, fans. I'm going to start doing this. We've been so excited. We haven't
into the game for your motion, number 39.
A couple more sponsors here. So I want to thank Brandon Carson from Brunswick Rural Realty. Amazing. He came in super early. Eastgate Academy, ED1 Home Appraisals, and Ehrman Plumbing. I'm going to start with them, guys. You've all been amazing. Ehrman Plumbing and Heating, pardon me. You guys have all been amazing, and we thank you, and we're going to get through all of our sponsors as we go out the rest of this game. So, Adam, I'm going to hand things over to Mr. Kendrick as Timmy Mitchell lays it in and brings the lead down to three. So we'll get Timmy to come all the way around, and I'll hand him my headset, and you can have a little chat with him as we approach halftime here.
Absolutely. So just over 5 minutes left to play here. Moncton's up by 3, 42, 39. And the three-point attempt, short. Moncton grabs the offensive board. They've been aggressive on the boards tonight, which is always nice to see. Tough company. Champagny. Montenegro short. Hit a couple of those tonight. Not this time. So once again, welcome to the Avenir Center. I'm Adam Gould, and I'd like to welcome to the broadcast table Mr. Tim Kendrick.
Hello, Adam. Nice to be here. Thank you.
Nice to have you here. Familiar face. Well, I never enjoyed playing against you. You were always one of those coaches where I was like, ah, crap. We're in for a tough night tonight. But tell us a little bit about your role with the league here and what's happening tonight.
Well, thanks, Adam. I'm just thrilled to be the president of the Eastern Canadian Basketball League.
Time out, Bathurst.
And, you know, our thing is we really want to help make communities better within the Maritimes. And you know, it's important, I think, for everybody to understand that we want to be here for decades. We want to be in each of our franchises for decades. And, you know, we want to do whatever we can to help with the communities. But mostly through the minor basketball as we go forward, we want to get both boys and girls and maybe get out to the schools a lot and the boys and girls clubs and, you know, do whatever we can to help the communities grow and prosper.
That's awesome. A couple things to unpack from that. I love that you want the franchise to be here for decades because as a fan and part of the team, of course, we understand business is business, but to go from the miracle to the magic to win the championship and then to have the team, you know, no longer continue, it's a bit tough. So to hear that the intent is to be here for decades, as you mentioned, is really awesome.
Yeah, well, thank you. And that's a big thing with our league. You know, we that's why we're going to stay completely in the Maritime Provinces. We're not looking to leave the Maritime Provinces. We're going to stay right here. We'd eventually love to grow to 10 teams. And, you know, we're very excited because we already have a number of teams looking to maybe try to get into the league as early as next year. So
that's
we're
great.
Really pleased with the outcome early from what we've seen around the league.
Right on. And I love your shout-out to the minor basketball associations. I mean, myself, you know, the MKNBA, as it was back in the day, was critical in helping me, you know, build some skills to eventually make the high school and university teams. You know, shout-out to Roger Cormier. But I think the biggest thing that has impressed me tonight has been the turnout from the Moncton fans.
Oh, it's been just wonderful, and we couldn't have asked for more. You know, you've got a great group here, you know, with David and the coaching staff and everyone, right from, the head of the Avenir Center has been wonderful to deal with for us. And that's been the same at every place we've been. You know, Bathurst is just wonderful. St. John's, we can go right down the line, you know. And we're just thrilled that the people have shown up and support it like they have, you know. And you know, the one thing I really believe it's going to get better and better. I mean, this is a first-year venture right now. We know there's been, you know, some things people would like to see a little better and this and that. But please give us time because, remember, we plan on being here forever. So, you know, that's our thing. We'll get better and better as we go.
I love that. I don't think I've ever seen you smile so much. You didn't smile too much as a coach. But you were all business and you were effective as a coach, a great coach. And by the way, great work on addressing the crowd tonight, rather. As a public speaker myself, it's about engaging the crowd. And look, you went out there, you talked about, you seemed excited, happy, we were engaging. If I was just sitting in the stands, it was a great welcome from you as the president. And they don't always go well, so nice work. It was the message was well received. You got me fired up. And so it's nice to meet you in this capacity. And I think you're going to be a great president for this league. And whatever I can do to support you, just let me know.
I really appreciate you saying that. And again, we're just so thrilled that we're up and running now. And it's really important, I think, for everybody to understand. All we need, we just need your support around the league. And, we literally, our group in New York City, led by Mr. Verma, he's been just wonderful to deal with. And our whole thing is that we're going to get through this year best we can and put the best product out. But we're literally talking about being in these areas for decades. And we just need the support, and we want to do a lot in the
Montenegro.
Community. So we're thrilled to be here. Thanks so much for having me.
My pleasure. Thank you. Beautiful bucket from Jeff Montenegro. Folks, that's ECBL president, Mr. Tim Kendrick. And looks like he's really excited to bring some awesome basketball to Atlantic Canada. And thank you very much to Tim for jumping on the mic here. It's 44-41. Moncton's up 3 points here in the second quarter. 3 minutes left to play. I don't know about you guys fans, but I am really excited about this new season. Basketball is an amazing sport, and this town has a great history of supporting basketball teams in this city. And you're going to go back and watch that broadcast. Tim was just magical. Oh, what a great move.
Coast to coast. My
E-man. Goodness. In Thatchaway.
Emmanuel Natchez.
Guy moves really, really well for a guy his height.
Yeah, yeah. He's got skills. I mean, he's got skills. He's worked on his quickness a little bit too. Like that's the spot where he knows if he gets it even a little bit more, a little bit quicker, fleet of foot, it'll be even tougher to stop. That's a nice little move inside by Tim Mitchell. But what did I miss with Mr. Kendrick?
Oh man, Tim, like you'll go back and watch this or listen to this broadcast, and he was just electric. I was telling him I've never seen you smile ever, but now you're smiling so much. And as a coach, he was always very, very tenacious and obviously very successful. But man, he's just brimming from ear to ear.
Robbie,
he's a great ambassador
Robinson.
For the sport. I don't know him in that fashion, but when I commended him on his speech to welcome the fans, I think he's going to be a great leader for this league, and it was a really awesome chat. I think we're very fortunate to have him.
And Robbie Robinson got off the schneid a little bit with a nice little hezzy move. Missed box out, though, there by the motion. They get away with it.
5-point lead. Moncton up 48-43. Minute and a half left to go in the second quarter.
First half, close enough. Oh, yeah, I knew he was going to pop that one. Miambo skies for the rebound. Stanley, wide open. Missed assignment there by the motion, and a missed assignment on the box out.
Nice pass.
Gorgeous. The feed from Giovanni.
And it looks like Tim Mitchell is feeling better. He must have gotten a little bit of treatment on that shoulder.
Giovanni, he sounds like an artist, and he sure was on that feed.
Absolutely.
Oh, and Robbie.
I'm buying.
Another miss from the wing from Robbie. Just can't quite get himself going.
And now, I've never seen that falling back. He slipped. The ball made its way to him. He caught the pass and passed it from on the
without
ground.
Traveling. That's a fairly athletic maneuver.
And so quickly.
Yeah. Nice D there by James French.
Better offense.
Yeah.
The Bathurst Bears tie it up at 48 here with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half.
Looked like they were going to run away and hide a little bit, but Stanley Miambo, the New Brunswicker, again from deep. Oh, Montenegro just lost the handle a little bit, and here comes the push. Robinson, though, with a good D, and Papal runs it down. Montenegro now. He's got a 2-on-2, but he's going to wait for his buddies. Now he's going to penetrate again. A little step back and a step through. Montenegro with a bevy of moves.
Fouls on Bathurst number 4.
Just shake and bake around the back, up and under. And now Jeff, he's had a terrific first half, and he's got a chance to go to the line here and give the motion the lead back on the way into the locker room. Only 0.8 seconds remaining on the clock in the first half of play in the first game ever in the history of the Moncton Motion, and the fans appreciating the work of Mr. Montenegro here in the first half. As you prepare yourself for halftime, Mr. Gould, you'll be running the halftime show for us, and we're going to go to that break with a Moncton Motion leading 50-48. First game in franchise history, fans. We're going to see you back here in 15. Enjoy Mr. Gould on the mic running our halftime show. We'll see you back here in 15. We'll be right back.
check. Check, check. What's up, Moncton Motion fans? Thank you so much for coming out. We hope you guys are enjoying the basketball so far. This is our Sports Rock halftime show. Please give it up for Roman and Patrice, our two contestants. That's right. Our show tonight, our competition rather, is going to be each contestant has to make one layup, one free throw, and one three-pointer. And the winner of this contest is going to take home a gift certificate from Big League Burgers and Wings, part of the Sports Rock group. You guys ready to do this? Which baskets, which one taken? You want to go over here? All right, fans, let's give them a big round of applause. We got Roman and Patrice. One basket, one player on this side, one player on this side. All right. You can run. Whoever makes those three shots first, foul shot, layup, and three-pointer. All right. On your mark. Get set. Go. All right. Roman with the layup. Patrice with the layup. And Patrice makes the layup. Three-point shot. All right. Roman's behind. Now Roman makes the free throw. Patrice. Give it up for Patrice, the winner of our Sports Rock halftime show. Congratulations.
Folks, as you enjoy the rest of this halftime and all the timeouts throughout the game, we want to give a major shout out to our in-house DJ, DJ Markoshi.
So much you thought I was a DJ. Two, one, yep, three. S-E-N-double-O-P-D-O-double-G. Two, one, yep, three. I cut so much you thought I was a DJ.
When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Get an attitude. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rodeo on my arm and I'm pouring Sean down and I'm in the best. Cause I got it going on. I'm a nice dude with some nice dreams. See these ice cubes, see these ice creams. Eligible bachelor, $1 million bow. That's whiter than what's spilling down your throat. I'm a phantom, exterior like fish eggs. The interior like suicide was red. I can exercise you, this could be your phys ed. Cheat on your man, one, that's how you get a his head. Killer with the B, I know killers in the street. This good to make you feel like you're chilling in the heat. So don't try to run up on my head, talking all that rasp. Trying to ask me, big investor ain't gon' pass me. You should think about it, take a second. Matter of fact, you should take 4B and think before you a little skateboard P. When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Get an attitude, pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the Romeo on and I'm pouring Sean down and I'm over
there. Yeah, Spider-Man and freezing full effect.
You ready, Ron?
I'm ready.
I'm ready, Snake, are you?
Well, yeah, take it down.
Girl, I must warn you, I said something strange in my mind.
Yo,
situation is, let's kill it cause we're running out of time. It's all so beautiful, relationships they seem from the start. It's all so
blocks and blocks, let your backbone slide.
as the model, YOLO.
Well, we're seconds out here from the beginning of the third quarter, making history with the very first. Let's try that again. The very first Moncton Motion basketball game here.
History is made.
I did a rewind for you, but you didn't follow me.
Oh, so that's
I sounded like an idiot.
I didn't know what you were doing, but now that I know, can you try that one again? Nice.
Yeah. Welcome back for the second half of the.
We are refreshed, energetic. And not laughing because we are funny. We're laughing because we're just having such a great time here.
Yeah, I went around. I did some glad handing into the crowd. I saw some of the. We had some group tickets come in from Petticoatiac and from Sackville and from outside of the immediate area. So, and some of them are good friends of mine. I went and checked them out and said thank you. And they're loving it. They're absolutely loving it. They you know, and really, it's only going to go up from here. I mean. These guys, frankly, it's been, if anything, it's been a little sloppy, the basketball, but the fans don't care. The fans don't care, and they know some of these guys have been in town for a few days, and it's going to get, as these guys gel together and get to know each other's games, and they get to know each other's, and they get to know the coaches' systems, you know, and where they fit in them, they're just going to get the caliber, the level of play is going to get better and better, and yeah, the fans are excited. The fans are really excited, and they're... And there's a lot of encouragement by the number of fans in the stands, too. I mean, they really are encouraged, the fans, by the number of fellow fans that came out here and made an appearance in the Avenir. It's a really good crowd, and we couldn't be more pleased.
You know, it wasn't that long ago, like, you know, just a few hours, and for the last few weeks, we're just kind of anticipating, you know, this day and hoping that everything is going to go well. And you're always nervous because you care and you want things to go properly and be successful on one chance to make a good first impression.
Yeah.
We had all kinds of adversity this week that we had to face, but we overcame, we punched through, and here we are. And I don't know about you, Dave. I'll speak for myself.
I'm so pleased with the way that today turned out. I couldn't have asked for better as far as the outcome of the product that we got from the fans showing up. Mm-hmm. Everyone that I spoke to at halftime is over the moon. People are talking about buying season tickets. Like, people are freaking out. We've created some really awesome hype here today. And I think everyone involved, including yourself, should be proud. And got some really good comments on the broadcast, too. Says people are laughing that we're a good pair, and sounds like we're having fun doing
all
a great
right.
job.
Well, we appreciate it, fans. And we appreciate any of the feedback you have for us. So welcome to the ECBL, and welcome to the Dave and Adam show on the live stream for the Moncton Motion.
People either love us or hate us, but if you hate us, that's just because you're not having enough fun.
Yeah, that's got to be it.
You know, let's have some
Couldn't
fun here
today. Could be any other reason. As Jenkins.
Oh, beautiful.
I thought
stroke.
That was
me too.
Looked good from our angle.
Sure did.
Defense. Jenkins, and he was really standout for me in the first half, Janiel, as I knew he would be just from watching. The term water bug comes to mind for Janiel, doesn't it?
Yeah, I don't know what that was. Can you elaborate?
You know what I mean by water bug? You know
water
those,
bug?
Those bugs in the water. They dance all over the place. They're so fast.
No, I don't know what I mean.
People out there in broadcast land. Okay, you fans, take sides for me. Water bug, yes or no? Or am I crazy?
I heard water book, so I was just
Okay. Well, no, water bug. Water bug.
Dog
water
book? Ate my homework or something.
Water book? What are you talking about?
I don't know, man.
Oh, yeah, there's a basketball game going on.
Right.
So 50-48.
We should comment on that.
No score so far in the third quarter. Robbie Robinson still struggling to get that shot going.
They are putting a lot of pressure on him.
Sure they are, yeah. And he's taking
shots.
Oh,
wow.
That's a
beautiful make from Shaquille Gilgeous Glasgow.
Yeah, that was pretty. And he looked like he took a hit there, too. Went down in a heap.
SGG.
That's right. And it's a 51-50 lead now for Bathurst, seeking their first win of the season after two early losses. These motion trying to get off the shot. And again, Robinson just can't get it to go. Stepping in there was Champagne. Looked like he caused the travel, but kept that dribble alive and finished it. O.J. Watson. So now stuck three here are the Magic. Davis calling on our man, the water bug, for the handoff.
I got to meet Paul from the Bathurst Bears. He's the GM of the team. He was asking about you. I had an opportunity to chat with Paul on the phone, you know, a few weeks ago.
Yes, absolutely.
And they had their home opener this past Sunday.
He wanted to steal you.
Yeah.
Paul wanted to steal you.
Yeah, he did.
From me.
Yeah, he did. But you know I love you, brother. So
I wasn't going to let that happen.
No, man. Well, you know, and I love Bathurst, but I do live here, so I really would much prefer being here.
Sorry, I missed you, Paul. I missed you on the rounds. I'll try to find him after the game.
Yeah, shout out to Paul.
Yeah.
Director of Basketball Operations for the Bathurst Bears.
Oh, yeah, doing great work up there in Bathurst.
Love that there's a good basketball team in Bathurst, you know.
Look at Tristan Davis working down there.
Once again, Robbie Robinson frustrated on that play.
Tristan Davis!
Speaking of Bathurst, the pull move, the BMHS...
Miramichi Valley,
Pullamoo, rather, and the Bathurst team?
The Phantoms.
Thank you. Man, they always had a really competitive team.
They did. Oh, short on that one was Miambo. He's had a good night, but that was well defended by the motion, and Miambo came up short.
Ooh, yeah, that's a blocking foul there for sure.
Yeah.
It's going to be on Giovanni.
Giovanni Jackson.
Giovanni, like
the name of an artist. He had himself a first half that was pretty as a picture, Adam.
Just
Mr. Jackson. A couple of forays into the paint. And then a nice little three from the wing. Oh, ooh. Robbie Robinson. Just missed bringing the crowd to his feet with that one.
And the other way, good for two, O.J. Watson. To stretch the Bathurst lead to five, I believe, once the scoreboard updates here for us.
Jackson, yeah, Giovanni with the handoff again. Effective putting that ball on the deck. Oh, nice handoff. Just lost it going up. Oh, man, the hustle, though. Yeah, well done.
Physical game here today. Both sides really wanted to make this a W for their team. Bathurst 0-2 at this point. They really, really, really want this win here in Moncton to spoil the season opener and home opener for the Moncton.
Yeah, but you see Janiel Jenkins there, the hard work and the hustle there. That was a 3-on-0 going the other way if he didn't work his way into position to create a new possession for his squad. Janiel with the pullback. And Tavier. Champagne in disbelief, and Mitchell.
I mean, I have to be on Champagne's side on that one. His arm got locked underneath, but
I don't know. He's pretty Champ Eddie. He's pretty sneaky. He's played. He's played pro a lot of places.
I don't have the benefit of knowing that, so I guess he pulled a fast one on me.
I think maybe he did. I'm not. I'm just saying the referee could have made the right call there because he might have done that old hook.
Yes.
And pull it. Oh, what? I'm not the one hooking. He's hooking. I think he probably was. I think that probably was the right call as Mitchell missed the fadeaway and Montenegro collects.
Moncton stuck 3, 55-52, just above 8 minutes left to go. Quarter number 3, home opener for the Moncton Motion, brand new ECBL franchise.
Oh, Montenegro just can't finish.
Nice effort. He's so tough getting to the basket.
He is, yeah. That wide frame of his he uses so well. Wards off the defense, just a little too strong on that layup attempt.
Directly across from us at center court, Al Norman and Jerrica, owners of the Tire Shack Brewery Company. Congratulations to them, and thank you for their support.
Absolutely.
Beautiful three-pointer. That one's good for Bathurst. Stanley Mayombo.
He's had himself a game, and Stanley, the New Brunswick native, playing some pro ball in his home province.
506.
That's right, representing.
Bathurst up 6, 58-52. Montenegro pops. Good for two.
That's got to feel good for Jeff.
Montenegro.
Pulling the boys back within four. Jeff's had himself a good night. The perimeter J hasn't really been there consistently for the motion. That's really been their issue, but it's been there for Mayombo, and he pulls the string again.
Stanley Mayombo.
Stanley.
For three.
Doing work in the Hub City, and he's gotten his team out to a 7-point lead. Jenkins and Robbie Robinson working the two-man game. Yeah, Jenkins on the reach in and the Bathurst bench. They ain't pleased about that call.
Thoughts on Bathurst, number 23.
Special shout-out, as we mentioned, going out to Tire Shack Brewing Company, one of our sponsors for this season.
Yeah.
And a big congratulations going out to them. They won the Canadian Brewery of the Year, beating out over 1,000 other brewing companies. Congratulations.
Yeah, I mean, it's and that's they've won a couple of those awards. That's the most prestigious one they've won so far.
Oh,
but
yeah.
They've won
the best brewery in the entire country.
Yep.
That's incredible. A little small brewing company out of Moncton, New Brunswick here. Huge expansion at their location. And check them out, Tire Shack Brewing Company on Dominion and John in Moncton.
And that's nicely done there by Tristan Davis. I knew he felt like he didn't get a call there, but he stuck with it. Got the ball to E-Man, and E-Man, who's been perfect at the line tonight, for the motion, he's got a chance to bring this a little closer.
That's his second.
And he does. Thank you, E-Man, for disproving the jinx.
Once again, big shout out to our official DJ for this season, DJ Markoshi, crew leader of a DJ, four-piece DJ crew called something that we won't just say at this moment, but we do appreciate him coming down this season. We'll be getting some support from the rest of his crew.
He's been amazing. The fans are loving the tune so far.
Yeah.
Like, it's been
so
entertaining.
Great guy, too. Super solid, very reliable. Been playing since 1995.
Oh, nice. Mayombo trying again.
Nice.
Oh, boy.
At the end of the shot clock.
Head shake.
Drains it. A little bit of trash talking going on between some of the guards here. Just
well, listen, when you're shooting the ball like Stanley, talk it up.
Absolutely.
You know, you don't like it. Stop it.
Brush that dirt off your shoulder, son.
That's right. Oh, Davis thought there was a roll coming, and it wasn't.
No look. It leads to a turnover.
Yep, and that's going to be a timeout, and it is. He needs one. Giovanni Jackson on the lay-in. The lead is 8 for the Bears.
Moncton stuck 8, as Dave just mentioned. Score is 56 for Moncton and Bears 64. Just under 6 minutes of play here. A timeout in the third quarter.
Come out mauling here. So I've got a couple of... I mentioned Don Ehrman, Ehrman Plumbing and Heating, and Don Ehrman, who I went to high school with, and is that company is stalwart of the community for a long, 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 long time.
Absolutely.
And shout out to her for getting some members of Harvest House out here to the game tonight. She did. She worked some magic a little bit and got some of the guys from Harvest House here out, joined Annette out in the town while they're working to, you know, get better over there at Harvest House, all the great work that the people at Harvest House do. So shout out to Ehrman Plumbing and Heating and Don Ehrman. Thanks for that. Shout out, too, to Papa John's, some members of the Papa John's crew down here in front, sitting in their courtside seats, stopped me on the way back and mentioned how much fun they were having here sitting in the front row. So shout out to Papa John's, all the great work they've done for us. And we'll get to some more little, we'll thank everybody here as we go down through the rest of the game. But Heather Elliott with the Mortgage Center, we want to thank Heather. She came on pretty early as a season ticket holder and then wanted to convert to a sponsor when she found out she could do that. So shout out to Heather and Pear Tree Vacations. And last one we'll hit before we get back to the action here. Shauna Scott Realtors. Thanks, Shauna, for supporting the motion here first year.
And although these sponsor reads are not necessarily the most entertaining or engaging for our fans listening to the broadcast here tonight, it is critical that without this support, this team doesn't exist. We rely on, of course, ticket sales to keep the team afloat, but definitely the support from corporate and local businesses. So a big thank you going out to anyone who has shared their resources with us to get this team off the ground here today on our home and franchise opener.
Yeah, when you hear that, when you hear a name, we mentioned fans of a sponsor on here, please go check them out. Check out their socials. Check out their business. Just give them a shout out. Give them a look for doing what they do for us here. Jenkins gonna have to get one up against the shot clock, and he does, and he gets hit.
So we still have an 8-point Bathurst lead, 64-56, 5.5 minutes left, quarter number three.
Fouls on number four, Giovanni Jackson.
A little brush there. That's from Jackson, third. Giovanni. That's his third, I think I heard from our esteemed Tia Bailey. And the first one goes in for Janelle. He's going to have two more.
Hey, I just got a... This is a really impressive stat. Dave, we have 1,060 people tuned into the stream at this moment.
That's awesome.
I mean...
That's big.
I know this is a small market, but that's a good number.
That's a very good number. That's a very good number.
I don't know if I've been on, NBLC stream or, previous league stream that's not the NBA with that many views. So thank you so much to everybody for tuning in.
That's a really big number. We're really happy to hear that. I hope fans of you come back. I hope fans of you keep supporting this league. The league's only going to get bigger and better, and we're going to get there by with everybody joining in and checking us out and coming out and watching these guys and getting to know them.
Absolutely. And that news came in from Jamie Como. He's the president of Production Atlantic. He's the technical director here at the Avenir Center. Great guy, and he's working remotely from Toronto right now on this stream. So shout out to Jamie and his team, and specifically to Andrew, who's our tech today. He's been amazing, running all over the place to make sure everything's looked after in Jamie's absence. So shout out to the technical team, as always. The unsung heroes of this, they sometimes don't get the props that they deserve, but without those guys and girls, we can't do our job. So big shout out to the technical crew at Production Atlantic.
Yeah, and check out the live stream, fans, for each game. What I would do, fans, because we're not putting up the live streams until right before the game. So make sure you go to, if you can't make it to a game, we want you here. Get out to the building. But if you can't make it, make sure you go to the socials of the teams that are hosting before the games. You'll find the live streams there.
And you know what else you guys could do, girls? Y'all can subscribe to notifications on the Moncton Motion YouTube channel or on the Facebook page so you can stay in the loop in all things Motion basketball, including home games this year.
Yeah, that was a pretty play there by E-Man to set up Tristan Davis. Tristan would love that one back, but he gets back, doesn't hang his head. It Montenegro. Creates a turnover. James French! Crab onto that one, Adam.
Absolutely. Nice box out on the Bathurst side. Moncton's cut the lead to five from Bathurst.
Oh, look at that D in there by Ndachue.
Up to French.
Oh, boy. Nice D there by Mitchell. Mitchell's coming out a little more focused in this quarter, Adam. Not letting the physical play and the calls and the opposition get in his head.
It seems like he's calmed his head a little bit. Yeah, they had him frazzled for a bit.
Yeah, they did.
It was a nice drive by Davis, but met at the basket by Tim Mitchell.
Yep, turned away.
Not today.
Yep.
Here we go.
Not this time, anyway.
Defense! Defense!
Moshe's going to have to turn up the defense here a little bit, and here's the man that's been causing the problems, Stanley Miambo.
Great ball handling.
Montenegro sticking right with him. Mitchell, you work on the screen there with Watson. Back out to Moore. Moore's going to have to create.
5 second shot clock. It's running down.
Oh, boy.
Great defense from Moncton.
Yeah, Holmes had one there. He probably should have used it. Oh, nice little lob in there, but read perfectly by Miyombo. Run down by Moore.
Nice job of Jenkins getting back on that one.
Yeah. Mitchell trying to go to the Euro step.
Wow.
That was pretty good defense, actually, by
quick feet for a big man.
That was, yeah. No, Tim's always had that gift. He's always had those quick feet.
Doesn't have to be pretty to be effective.
No, it doesn't. And that was good defense. And it goes to show right there, E-Man, pretty good defense.
Yeah, absolutely.
Played him body up. Just Tim just finished through the contact. And there we go.
Triple from Jenkins.
That's been missing from the motions.
Montenegro with the... with the steal on the inbound.
Defense.
Yeah. Unfortunately, 3-on-1 outmatched.
Defense.
Yeah, that was probably, you're right, 3-on-1. Probably should have pulled that one back.
Yeah.
I don't know if the score's not right, fans, if you're seeing it on the live stream. It's not a 10-point game right now. We're going to fix that in a minute as Montenegro smartly pulls it back and leaves it for Jenkins,
who made the three on the previous possession, two possessions ago, rather.
Yep, it's going to stay, though. With the motion there, that's
there
that.
Go.
The score adjusted.
That makes
I knew.
More sense.
Yeah, 66-62. That's better news for us. As you see, the MVP Modern Barbers ad go up. Fans, stay tuned after the game, Adam. Right, we're going to be doing a little presentation.
Absolutely, we will have our player of the game brought to you by MVP Modern Barbers, who are a company out of St. John. Recently, took over the old graffiti building next to the Times Transcript downtown. Iconic building in this city, has had many, you know, beautiful spots, but it's been abandoned and kind of closed for about a decade. So really nice to see them take tenancy in that building. And
spot we took them to MVP Barbers is next to the Superstore out near Dieppe, and they've got the spot we took them to out there. Shane and Anna, I think was their name.
Shane. Okay.
Shane and Anna, the two ladies that handled E-Man and Andre Frazier, who's injured right now and on the bench. And fans, we can't wait to see Andre play. Hopefully he's back in a couple weeks. We're hoping. We've got our fingers crossed for Andre and Jeff Montenegro. The three of those guys went out there and they got lined up and they had an absolute blast out there at MVP Barbers, and those ladies treated them like gold.
That's awesome.
And they came out of there looking like pristine.
So fresh and so clean.
So
clean.
Fresh and so clean, clean. You got it.
Makes me want to get those steps in the side of my hair again.
Yes.
Remember those?
Yep.
I legit would do those if I could.
Did you say again?
I did. I for sure had steps
All right.
In my teens and 20s.
You know me, man. I've had the same haircut since I was 4.
Well, the bowl's getting old, Dave.
That's right.
Shout out to my mom for giving me all those bowl haircuts. Nice little display of verticality.
Yeah, you got to jump over those courtside seat fans every now and then.
O.J. Watson.
And coming back in is... man with the name we love, Shaquille Gilgeous, Glasgow.
SGG.
E-Man with the take. Not able to finish. Back come the Bears.
Still a 4-point lead for Bathurst, 66-62. Moncton down 4.
And Robinson back in for the motion. And Adam, he's going to have to get on track, I think, here.
Yeah, he was shaking a little bit early with a few misses, and it looks like he's maybe forcing it a little bit too quickly on the possession. But
yeah,
obviously, it looks like he's...
Robbie's a pretty mentally tough guy. So, yeah, what his expression doesn't change. So if he's frustrated, he's not showing you. But, I mean, he just hasn't had that kind of game that you're used to seeing out of Robbie. The game we've seen. He's just been a wreck. He's just been a destroyer of worlds in this... area of the country in pro ball for a long, 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 long time. He just hasn't gotten on track tonight, so he's still got a full quarter plus here to drag his team to over the finish line. But, yeah, it's really been the play. I think, I mean, the most impressive member of the motion tonight for me has been Janelle Jenkins. I mean,
absolutely.
Terrific stuff from Janelle.
Yeah, definitely. And side note, shout out to Matt Robertson.
Yes.
Moncton native, played with the Magic, now on the coaching staff. With the Moncton Motion, great guy. What's up, Matt? Great to see you again.
And a shout-out to a couple of, just again, fans, we want to encourage to check out our sponsors. This guy doesn't need any encouragement. He's got He's got his business on lock, and that's Dr. Martin Braces.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Doc Braces, man.
I visited that building many, many a time. My oldest has his braces as we speak. I'm visiting him often, and they do terrific work there, and they've been super supportive of basketball in the community. The Hoop Classic they support, now the Moncton Motion, and the ECBL. So thanks so much out there to Dr. Martin Braces.
And on that note, if you are interested in getting involved with sponsorship for the Moncton Motion, please contact us at david.tingley, T-I-N-G-L-E-Y, at ecbl.ca. We're going to be going out with a new sponsorship package here in the next couple weeks, and we're definitely looking for some more support. So if you're interested in getting involved, let us know. And, of course, if you want to be a presenting sponsor of this broadcast, we're definitely looking for some more support there as well. So another great defensive possession by Moncton. 24-second shot clock violation from Bathurst.
Yeah, Mr. Holmes banked it in, but it was too late. And it's back to the Motion, and they got some chances here to drag this back. I mean, it feels like
this third quarter went by really quick.
Yeah. It's kind of had that feel that the Bears should be in the lead by more than four. It's kind of get that feel, you know what I mean?
Like, yes. Moncton is very fortunate to be stuck only four at this
point. Yeah, they just haven't played well. Like, I've seen these guys practice, and this has not been indicative of how well they can play Coach McKillop's systems, but boy, that was an athletic block.
Did you notice how all the players swarmed around Robinson when he took the lane? So they have his number. Robinson needs to drive and kick at this point.
Yeah, it'd be, and Jamar, that was an athletic play. I mean, I think Robbie in that situation thought he had him. There's a nice move baseline, but no, not, just can't get it to go.
Oh, that,
and that
I'm is, not a referee.
Yeah, if that had been picked up, if that hadn't been picked up by his teammate, that would have been a travel. Oh, another nice deflection there
off
for the Motion. Really,
off the shot clock?
Yeah. Really not letting Bathurst get into their stuff. I'm not sure what Coach Langis is talking about. Oh, maybe a reset. Maybe the shot clock. He felt like. That's 14. Actually,
yeah, I thought, but they had it at 24, so that's what it would have been. Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
So 107
solving all the
left.
World's problems.
Yeah, 107 left third quarter. 4-point game here in Moncton. Oh, digging in for the steal. Well done. Now Robbie's got some numbers.
And
oh, so close.
Janiel Jenkins with the drive and
double
foul.
Double J.
Double J.
Almost
double G.
Almost with the hit and the harm. Double R to double J, but no good.
We're so cool.
We are.
Aren't we?
In our own minds, we are.
We are in our own minds. You know, some of the feedback that I got in the previous seasons when we worked together is that people like that we didn't take ourselves too seriously. Well, guess what, folks? You're in luck again. We have still not begun to take ourselves seriously.
We're back.
Yeah, we're back. And if you want some basketball dialogue and some laughs, tune in.
Yeah.
Every home game
and
this season.
Some obscure references that someone will have to explain to you.
Oh, absolutely. From all areas, sports and culture.
Yeah. We'll have one of those, one or two of those every night.
Oh, boy. I think I'm going to put together a little-known fact list. Oh, wow. Throwing it down. 2 points on the slam dunk from Brandon Jamar.
Yeah. That was good stuff. That's what Bathurst has been getting, a little bit of that action at the rim out of their screen roll action.
Yeah, Moncton's getting stuck on that pick and roll.
And they just haven't. That's been the key. Moncton hasn't made any jumpers to loosen up that Bathurst defense a little bit. It's been few and far between.
A lot of turnovers.
Holmes kind of fumbles it.
A lot of turnovers forced by Moncton, but not converting on those is what's killing us right now.
And there's Jenkins. He's going to convert on
beautiful,
the finish.
Beautiful. Jenkins with the reverse layup. 2-point lead for Bathurst. 12 seconds to go. Quarter number three.
Janiel's becoming a fan favorite, you can tell already.
Absolutely.
I've officially given him the nickname the water bug. You're not going to like it because you don't understand it, but that's what it is. Getting away with one there.
And at the end
of the Motion.
At the end of the third quarter, Bathurst Bears 68, Bathurst Moncton 68. Motion 66. Better end to the quarter for the Moncton Motion,
so
but it seems like that was a tough one for us.
Yeah, but
Papa
again,
John's
it feels
pizza.
Like if you're
in every game, we will be giving
the
away
Bathurst
two
Bears.
Pizzas.
Sorry, Adam, I've destroyed our setup here that you've worked so hard to set up. I'm going to keep talking while you fix my mic. Attaboy.
No problem.
So
you can do this if you need to.
Yeah, there you go. So, yeah, if you're a Bathurst Bears fan, you're sitting there here going, doesn't it feel like we should be up by a lot more? And it does. It has that feel. It just doesn't feel like the Motion have played at their best. They're still trying to find it a little bit, which is, you know, not shocking, considering, like I say, fans, some of these guys have been in for only a few days and working in the system. So this is how this works. And fans of the old league knows there were always guys being signed late. You know, this is how these leagues work, as we've mentioned. So, you know, this is going to be – it's going to be the level of play is going to get better. These guys are going to get more comfortable here, you know, and they've – but they've done – you know, they've done a good job defensively staying in it while they're figuring themselves out a little bit offensively, the Motion, for sure.
Absolutely. I also want to give a special shout-out to Dwayne Tingley. For people in the Moncton area, they're most likely familiar with this man. He's a reporter for many, many years, and he's the vice president of the league here. So we do want to say a big thank you going out to Dwayne Tingley and all of his efforts here for the Moncton basketball community of all three teams. And, yeah, thanks again. And Taya Bailey, our in-house PA announcer and jack of all trades, also just came over and told us that there's over 1,000 people online for the broadcast. So for those people listening and tuning in, we hope that you're enjoying the level of play. We hope you're enjoying the broadcast. And if you're not, let us know. We're always here to improve and just have a good time. So on behalf of myself and my colleague Dave Tingley, it's our honor to be here today. And we're very proud to be part of the broadcast team for this year's Moncton Motion professional basketball team. Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah. And again, just as I hear this awesome song from Outkast play in my left ear, shout out to our official in-game DJ for this season, DJ Markoshi, one of my great friends. And he was voted as Moncton's number one DJ last year in the community votes poll. And
oh, nice.
Not surprised. So
shocking me not a little bit.
Right. Quick story. I was the DJ here for the World Juniors Hockey Championships in December. World stage, my gear crapped out on me, and I just put a Hail Mary on Facebook. You know, can somebody help? And this guy that I had never met dropped me off his $3,000 piece of equipment from Hillsborough just so that I could use that. So he ultimately saved my tail, and I have eternal respect for that man. I'm very grateful, and I'm fortunate to be able to call him a colleague and a friend.
Nice.
Such as yourself.
Well, I'm honored by that as well.
Nice take to the rim.
Yep.
E-man. From Ndachwe.
And E-Man going to the line. E-Man.
It's so funny. You kept calling him E-Man, E-Man. I was looking for like an Iman, like I-M-A-N, but it was like Emmanuel. So
Emmanuel.
Took me a while. Slow this week. I've had a couple late nights getting ready for this this game this week.
That's right.
But worth every minute of lack of sleep is this amazing feeling of being here on the broadcast. It's almost like a dream come true, and I'm not even being silly about it.
I know you're not. You're being genuine, and same for me. It's been amazing.
It hasn't been easy to get here, but now that we're here, like I said, when we get to the game, it's going to be incredible. And another shout out to Taya Bailey, who at lunch today, you know, he was the positive guy, keeping us motivated. No stress on game day today here, folks.
Absolutely. That's your mantra, and we're living it, buddy.
Heck yeah. Ooh, big take. That is a charge. Moncton draws the offensive foul. Oh, pardon me.
No, I think they called a block, yeah.
No way.
Yeah, yeah. That's a tight one. I could see that one going both ways. Well, I mean, that one's...
I saw his fist come out. Yeah, I think he may... Anyways, I'm just going to stop talking on that one.
No, I think so. But that'll happen sometimes. You see it, and then... Because what they're doing...
They're looking for the other refs for...
Well, you know what it might have been, though? It might have been that his feet were in the semicircle.
Right.
It might have been something that he called and then he looks down.
Right.
That can happen sometimes. But, you know, the second call is the right one in that scenario, if that was the case.
Nice to hear the Moncton fans making some noise during the opponent's foul shots. We're starting to get into our groove here.
Yes, getting into it a little bit as the game gets tight here and they get into the fourth quarter. The fans are picking things up again.
You know, it's been a long 3 years as
Giovanni Jackson finishes for two. Yeah, we've been waiting a long time.
Yeah. And it's 3 long years without basketball. There was a little hiccup along the way, some sort of, you know, thing that happened that people couldn't do stuff. But guess what? Things are back to somewhat normal. I'm friggin' grateful to be here. I'll never take an opportunity like this for granted again. And what a huge block from the Bears, Brandon Jamar, at the rim. They're now up 4 again, 72-68 Bears lead. Bit of a frantic pace from both teams here in this fourth quarter. And there's a turnover by Bathurst, picked up by Robbie Robinson.
little give and go, and good for two.
That was the right decision by KP to get it back to Robbie.
Meat and potatoes right there.
And it's one of those ones, too, when you're a scorer like Robbie, you see one go down, even if it's just a layup. You see one go down, and it unlocks something for you. If he can get going here late, it's going to make a massive difference to the Motion's mental makeup. But, again, those long rebounds, a couple of those from Bathurst, they've come back to them because
Motion's
not
Robinson.
Quite been on point with those box outs on the perimeter.
No.
Long shots,
going.
Long rebounds. You got to get out there and pin your man.
Yeah. Yeah, my basketball coach, Roger Cormier, if you did not box out, man, that guy would just blow like a vein every time. I just boxed out, you know what I mean?
Well, that is, and who was another one of his proteges?
Marc-Andre LeBlanc, Serge Langis.
Serge Langis on the bench of the Bathurst Bears. He'll tell you all about the influence of Roger Cormier.
Yeah, one of my most influential people in my entire life. So, Roger, if by chance you're listening to this program, you influence a lot of people, including myself. Thank you for being you, and I hope you're doing well and that you're still connected to the game of basketball, buddy.
And Tristan getting into the paint, looking to finish with the left hand. He's gotten in there and been turned away a few times, but nice to see him staying at it. Tristan Davis, he's super quick and strong with the ball in his hands. Dynamic. Had a chance to tie the game. Misses the first one, though. He's going to have one to come. And he's 0 for 2 at the line, and run down there by Holmes.
We'll take it. It just keeps us stuck by 2 instead of 4. Just under 10 minutes to go. Final quarter of play. In our very first home game here as the Moncton Motion franchise.
Getting into the paint and finishing there are the Bears, and that's Giovanni Jackson again. The artiste Giovanni pushing that lead back out to 4. And Tim Mitchell on the bench talking to the scorer's table, talking to everybody. A gregarious guy. As McLaughlin, he's had some key hoops for the boys.
I was just going to say, he's had a really good, well-rounded game.
Yeah, he's had a couple of these jumpers that they have managed to make have come off the fingertips of Mark.
He got us off to a good start in the first quarter, nailing a 2 and a 3 in the first 5 minutes.
Yep, and a miss there. Now the Magic have a chance to tie and take the lead again. And they got the ball in the hands of the right guy right now. Can he do it? And Robbie Robinson,
keeping it alive.
Motion ball.
I know you were a guard and I was a forward, but
yes.
I loved rebounding. I love banging in the boards. I really, really enjoyed being down there getting physical. Like you're not getting that ball.
Dude, I'm shooting the ball from 3-point line. You guys can rebound. I'm good.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Yeah. I shot 100% from 3 in my career. 2 for 2.
Oh, no way.
2 for 2. And both times I thought Roger was going to have an aneurysm.
If anybody can corroborate this, I'm not sure. You're not a teller of tall tales.
Especially on a public broadcast that is recorded forever. But the funny part, every time both times, he would just be like, no! And then it goes in. Of course, you're happy, right? But
another chance to lead.
I was hoping to say, speaking of three-pointers that go in, but not today.
Now, Davier can make that, though. And he's been, like I said, he's been drilling that movement over and over and over again. Solid box out there by Champagne. Holmes was trying to get in there, but out comes Tristan looking to push.
And push he does. Draws the contact. He'll shoot 2 at the line.
Good push from Tristan, and back into the game comes Mr. Montenegro.
I've been really impressed with his play. I'm not talking about the stats on the stat sheet, but his overall tenacity, the speed, the aggressiveness.
That's his second personal foul.
You know, got really good vision on the floor.
Yeah.
Covers a lot of distance.
Yeah. And he's a quiet type, is Jeff.
Bit of a sleeper.
Yeah, he's a quiet guy, but he is a super, along with everybody else on this team, a super nice fella. And I've enjoyed being around him these last couple weeks, getting to know him a little bit. That fade looks good. Look at that haircut. MVP Barbers.
I was just going to say, I feel like I need a haircut from MVP Barbershop.
He's looking good.
And he got the shave
done too. Look how tight he looks.
Yeah. Come on now.
If I oh, sorry, I'm gonna just leave that one right there.
Josiah Moore.
And he's all tied up at 74, folks. Just under eight minutes to play in the fourth quarter. It's been a competitive game.
And a real chance to take the lead now. And the step back.
Yes. As you mentioned, Robbie Robinson made that last shot. Saw the bottom of the bucket. And that was the best shot he's made all day.
I'm prescient.
He knew.
I'm prescient.
He knew. He knew that that was going in before it left.
Yeah, he looked super confident on the release. And that just comes when you work as hard as Robbie does, day after day after day, drilling shot after shot after shot. That's where that pays off. You can have a struggle all game, but you have that repetitive, in your brain, that reptile brain, that repetitive movement you've made over and over and over again.
The muscle memory.
And when you're an elite athlete, it just comes out at key moments if you're mentally strong, and that's what Robbie is. That was a huge one to give the motion the lead back for the first time in a while, Adam.
Yeah, it's. I feel like it's been about 15 minutes since we've had the lead.
And
the
D.
Nice jump ball.
Motion ball.
Tristan Davis.
Moncton up by three, 77-74.
And how about the fourth quarter from Tristan?
Oh, man, Tristan's been awesome this quarter.
Hasn't made all of his shots, but he's that super
energy.
Aggressive mindset.
Yeah,
correct. The energy on the defensive end of the floor. I'm a big fan of Tristan personally, and I'm glad he's had himself a good fourth quarter. I'm not sure it's possession went back to the Bears.
Oh, because it was jump ball, the arrow was going to them.
Yep.
Defense!
3 seconds on the shot clock. Can they get it off?
Oh.
Just in time, but no go. Oh, Stanley Mayumbo thrown away.
And Double R puts his hands up going, what did I just do? It's all right. That was you call that a sin of commission, not omission. That was an effort turnover. You were pushing the ball. It was the right idea. Just a little bit high for Jeff Montenegro to corral.
And we've got a couple ladies in front of us with red shirts from the United Way. One of them I know for a fact is Debbie McInnes. She's been involved for almost 40 years, and the United Way has been a great community partner with all three teams in the Moncton area.
Yes.
And shout out to the great people at the United Way that make a big difference to some of the most vulnerable people in this community. All proceeds do go to the 50-50. Tonight, to the United Way, and
that's the thing for them. They're not even getting the benefit of the 50-50 tonight. It's the Christopher Richard.
Correct. Thank you,
it's Christopher Richard's program,
right?
So they're
taking care of collecting.
But they knew that Krista would need some help.
Nice.
So when they knew it was Krista's program, they actually reached out to me and said, "Hey, can we help with the 50-50 for Krista?"
And man, that's so awesome.
I mean. Oh, and the fake.
Beautiful. Beautiful take by Jeff Montenegro.
Oh,
a little fakey.
Yeah, a little now you see me, now you don't from Jeff.
Little gabagoo.
And the motion are on a run in the crowd. You can feel the energy.
Man, what a powerful move from Tim Mitchell.
Oh, and he gives him a little too small for me.
Oh,
he gives him a little.
I missed that.
Davier's not going to like that one. Davier's going to come back on him. Oh, and he's going to shoot the step back.
Oh.
A little bit short, but you can see how frustrated he is. He knows that's a shot he can make consistently.
Sometimes when you're left too wide open, it plays tricks with your head. Oh, nice step.
Yeah,
nice jump step.
Stuff.
Josiah Moore.
Moore.
And just like that, the motion lead's been cut to 1. 79-78. 5 minutes, 30 seconds left to play in game number 1 of the season for the Moncton Motion.
That's a good setup. Well done from Montenegro.
Beautiful shot. Good
Guess
for three
who?
Points.
Oh, my. Call me 80. Kreskin. I knew that layup would unlock it. 2 for 2 from deep since that layup went.
Miyambo. Probably not the last one either. Oh.
Oh, boy. That was almost going the other way. Now it is. Oh, well done. Oh, but good
Montenegro
hustle from Montenegro.
Recovers. Back to Robbie Robinson.
Oh, yes.
Good for the bucket. Last 8 points for Robbie Robinson for the motion.
Absolutely. And Montenegro stuck with it. The stick-to-itiveness there. Looked like it was going to be a turnover.
And there's a battle going on down below in the
Penny.
Post.
That was wonderful stuff from Davier.
Yeah, Davier.
Oh, yes.
Nice hands, too.
Gets back and deflects the miss.
Beautiful defense.
And we got our under six timeout here. Fans in the motion on a run.
Moncton Motion up six, 84-78, 4.5 minutes left.
Tonight's winning number.
We also want to say a big shout out going out to a few more of our sponsors. We talked about Uni, we talked about Rehab One and the United Way, Papa John's and In Color. But we've got so many more.
Tonight's Multi-Radiator Service. I'm going to hit a few real quick.
Yeah, these are your people.
That have been with us super, super early that we haven't touched on yet.
Please.
Preferred Roofing, Multi-Radiator Services,
and it can be picked
Adored
up
Beast Apothecary,
Uproar
Productions, Karen Phytoplankton, Parlor Pond, and Troy Suchin's Cooperators. All those people there that you could find their links on our webpage, ecbl.ca. Go and check out our partners page there, fans. You can click on all these links there and see these. So those are all Moncton businesses that go, and their money goes to support this league in general, the ECBL. So that's the great thing about this community league. Every community partner, it doesn't only benefit the team in your hometown, it benefits the entire league as a whole and enables us to operate at a really high level. So
love that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you so much to everybody who has made efforts.
And I want to shout out two more, actually. I want to shout out two more.
No, go ahead.
Brand new in the last few days. CTB Plumbing, my man Clyde Brown, good friend of mine, went to high school with him. And IG Wealth Management, also, new sponsors, fans. We're getting more requests all the time for sponsorship, and we're really, really encouraged by that. And really, it's been a real brightener for us, even as this day approached. We really got an even bigger lift just from people being interested. And you know what it corresponded with, Adam? With these guys being in town and getting themselves out there and seeing their names and their faces and everything on social media, wearing the motion garb, being
Absolutely.
At practice, being out there in the community.
Absolutely.
The community's already started reacting positively to that.
And it makes it real, you know?
Oh, nice close.
Beautiful. Montenegro with the effort on the defensive end off the inbound and rewarded. Oh, back the other way. Oh, denied.
Nicely defense. Done by Mayambo, getting back and bothering him.
Defense.
I think Jeff thought he was going to use that. Oh, the flush. Excuse me.
Throwing it down for 2 points.
I was rudely interrupted
by
OJ.
A beautiful slam dunk. OJ Watson cuts it to four, 84-80.
But yeah, I think Jeff thought, oh, and that's a reach. That's going to go the other way. It's going to go our way. But
oh, we're going to take that call.
Yeah, absolutely. But Montenegro, I think he was going trying to use the rim as a protector there. But just a really athletic play from Mayambo.
Nice screen.
Oh boy, that looked good.
Yeah, Robbie Robinson short on that, or just a little bit hard on that one.
Just a little bit, yeah. Slight, but that was perfectly online. I think he's got that stroke feeling good again.
Definitely.
Yambo now with Montenegro facing up on him. This is where they've gotten their points tonight. Trying to take a charge there.
Ooh.
Was Montenegro, and look at the bodies flying at him.
That's a brave man standing in front of Tim Mitchell like that. Pretty significant size difference. Tim Mitchell's still down. Robbie Robinson's still down.
I think they're both just shaking it off, and they are.
And Montenegro's still on the deck. Hopefully he's okay. Man, crazy. And
almost took out three guys. Glad they're all on their feet and healthy.
Little bit of a random thing here, but our anthem, the gentleman that played the Canadian National Anthem at the beginning of the game, his name's Andrew Moore,
yep.
Good friend of mine, and he's to my left here. And I just looked over at him, and he kind of points at his ear. He has in-ear monitors that I set up for his performance.
Oh, he's listening to us.
He's listening to the whole game. He's getting the entire feed directly in his ears, aren't you, Andrew? Can you hear? You're hearing the whole broadcast here? Oh. Everything but us.
Oh.
Lucky him.
Well, that's the best of both worlds then. He's getting the best of it then. Doesn't have to listen to us.
Yeah,
but gets all the rest of the show.
Big shout out again to Andrew Moore. Did a great Canadian national anthem on the electric guitar. So if you haven't seen that, make sure you go back to the beginning of the broadcast and check that out. And you can check out his record, The Dip Session.
Make some noise.
And great, great musician, local musician, support live music. And thanks to Andrew for coming out.
In and out on both of those, and Double R collects the defensive rebound.
Moncton still up 4, 84-80. 3 minutes, 15 seconds remaining in the game.
Almost a turnover there, but Jenkins able to collect. He's going to have to get one up.
Oh, boy!
The triple from Mark McLaughlin. Moncton native.
Get the puppies organized.
Oh, boy.
Throws it down with Tim authority.
Get out of the way
for
Tim Mitchell.
Ouch.
This action's gotten a lot more back and forth. This is the way these guys can play, Adam, at this kind of pace, with this kind of scale. Look at the rejection.
Oh, another rejection.
Oh. And they called him for a foul.
And
no, they did not. No. I think they thought he got called. I think he thought he got called for a foul.
I like how a ref can make a call, and then his colleague can say, hey, no, I saw it from a better angle. This is the actual call. It's frustrating sometimes. It's beneficial sometimes.
Oh, yeah. Coach Langis is furious. He looked like and Coach McKillop gives him the wave.
Like, yeah, get out of here. Get out of here.
Mostly friendly, I think.
I love you, Serge, but not right now.
Yeah. That's the right call, though. That was not. I mean, it's definitely Bathurst ball, but.
Oh, that sounded bad.
It did, yeah. Tim hit the ground hard. It wasn't anything dirty.
Nope.
It was just Tim
fell right on his elbow.
Tim
I think.
Goes so hard when, all the time.
A big, big dude.
When guys collide, he took it away himself. And we heard the.
We're going to keep talking here, but once again, thank you fans for tuning in to Moncton Motion Basketball here on YouTube. We're live from the Moncton Avenir Center. The score is 87-82, 2.5 minutes remaining to play. I'm Adam Gules, my broadcast partner Dave Tingley, and we're joined at the scores table. Our PA announcer is Taya Bailey. Our official DJ for this year, again, as we mentioned, is Markoshi. And thank you so much for joining us. We're going to be here all season long, trying to do our very best to create a memorable basketball product for everybody that's not able to attend. But make sure, if you're able and in the area, that you come check out a live basketball game right here at the Avenir Center from the Moncton Motion.
And the fans are clapping for Tim Mitchell as he rises to a feet. That's a good sign.
He's okay.
Yeah. I think he's going to be banged up but not injured, which is that's the desired outcome.
Yes.
And
but man, that I we have headphones on with sound in them.
Yeah.
And I heard and felt that from here.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a big dude hitting the deck.
Yeah, well, Tim goes hard. He always has gone that strong to the hole, and when big bodies like that collide, it was Robbie Robertson getting up there. Robinson getting up there with him.
Yeah,
you know, forget it. He got vertical and just hit the floor.
Yeah.
So here's hoping
everything's cool.
Timmy bounces back. We're big fans of everybody in this league, not just the ones that wear our own uniform. We just happen to be bigger fans of the guys in our uniform.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Hometown crowd.
Noise. How about that three late by Mark McLaughlin?
Oh, man. Late in the shot clock.
Ooh, the fans went crazy.
Clutch.
This is going to be a fun ending as Jamar goes 2 for 2 at the line. That's big. Coming in for his front court mate, making both.
And he cuts it to 3. So it's 87-84. Just over 2 minutes left to play. 2:22 to be exact. Fourth quarter action here at the Avenir Center. Let's see if Moncton can hang on to this one. Sound defense.
Yeah, going Bobby into his
Robinson.
Bag.
Oh, what? Montenegro with the offensive board.
Yeah, that's nicely done by Jeff. Nicely read. He got himself right into the right position.
Montenegro trying to get in the paint. Does. Blocked. Gets his own board. Blocked again.
Wow, look at that effort from Jamar. And I think he's going to get teed up. Oh, they give a double technical. Jamar pushed him out of bounds.
Yeah, no, that was not a good sportsmanship play.
They're gonna offset the technicals. Yeah,
double technicals so offset.
I don't really mind that call. I thought they didn't. They had a chance to tee up Jamar. I think he blocked both those shots, and he was feeling himself a little bit, which I appreciate.
But you can't push the other player.
Yeah.
That ain't cool.
Looked like a clear push, and then they could have called him a tee. And then, you know, Jeff reacted, and obviously they called the – so I get why but the double tees were called. I think the single tee
might have been available earlier. But
speaking of single tees, 180 is you know, one of my favorite MCs out there.
God,
dropping a little.
Nicely done. Yeah. Yeah, nicely done.
Ow, now, Brown.
But it's been a we've had a comment on a couple of the calls. But this has been a really well ref game.
Agreed.
Like I say, you're going to have calls that you disagree with. Every basketball game, it's too difficult a sport to referee. But nice defense there from E-Man.
And it seems like the referees have been working together collaboratively to make sure they're making the right call.
Yep.
Where in the past, it's been kind of like, here's the call, I'm sticking to it. So, yeah, you just want it to be officiated properly if possible. So, steal from Bathurst.
Nicely done. That was well done there by Montenegro to get back and bother Josiah Moore.
How strong is that guy, man? Yeah, it's unbelievable. He's pound for pound. He's super, super tough. Man.
Absolutely. Look at the job that he did winning that. Winning that possession back
against a guy who's probably got 100 pounds on him.
Yeah, just a little bit of hustle.
See those nice red t-shirts down where the guy
yep, before the ball came in bounds. Timeout.
Timeout motion.
So motion timeout. So for anyone checking in, 87-84, Moncton up 3 minute and a half left. It's our first game of first home game of the season, and we couldn't be prouder to be here back at the Avenir Center for another season of Moncton professional basketball. You know, third time's a charm, as they say. And as League President Tim Kendrick mentioned when he was on the microphone here, their goal is to not only be involved in these communities, but to have these franchises stick around for decades. Were his exact words.
Yeah, and that's been they've got, you know, we've got 1 to 3 year plan, 3 to 10 year plan. They've got plans in the work. It's in the works.
When I hear,
they've got big ideas, but for the Atlantic provinces, the Maritime provinces,
the benefit of Atlantic Canada. Yeah.
Absolutely, he wants to. We're going to stay in PEI, New Brunswick, Nova Scotia. That's going to be our operating area. We're going to lift up rising tides, lift all boats, Adam, and we're going to lift up the game of basketball in these three provinces, and in return, the provinces are going to return that back on this league by providing players to play in this league in the coming years and decades. And that is the pipeline that they want to generate. And
I like that.
And that's an absolute thing. That's an absolute possibility for these players that are here, young in the stands, watching.
Yes,
they can go. Okay, I can play in this league.
Yes,
you got Mark McLaughlin playing in this league.
Yep,
you know you got James French playing in this league. These fans, these players that are sitting in the stands are looking at this, going, okay, well then let's get going.
And that's a great thing for the sport of basketball in this area of the world, and specifically in this community, because if you look at the hockey side of things, the kids that play hockey in this community will be able to eventually play for the Wildcats at some point. You know, it's an achievable dream to get to the queue, to then get you know, to the NHL, and I believe that this is a similar path, and it provides a platform for those athletes to have that opportunity and to create that kind of base to become quite good.
So it's crunch time, Adam.
Just a minute and 15 seconds, fourth quarter. Moncton up 3.
So running this weave out top.
Montenegro gets the 2. Beautiful finger roll.
Montenegro
takes the top key pick and slides right in there. 5-point lead.
Oh, the pretty kiss off the window for Jeffrey. And he's been terrific tonight as well. We got to pick the MVP player of the game. Adam, where are we going? We going Montenegro? We going...
I think it's either Montenegro or we're looking at Janiel Jenkins, but I mean, Jenkins probably has the better stats, but I feel like Montenegro had the better hustle. But I think I'm still going to go with Janiel Jenkins. What do you think?
I am torn. I'm gonna
very torn.
I'm gonna elicit the advice of maybe a third party on this. Oh, the step back,
Regis Philbin calling
defense.
I'm gonna use one of my call a friend.
Oh wow. Couple opportunities for Bathurst to get
the
tip.
Rim, yeah. And it's Montenegro coming out with it. McLaughlin on the take. Oh, he gets wiped out there by Tim Mitchell. Maybe he's in a greasy mood, maybe, Tim, after getting knocked down. That was quite the swipe.
And McLaughlin's feeling spicy. He's going in there saying, I don't care if I get bodied up and I get smashed on the ground.
Absolutely.
And now, inside.
To top off a great evening, Adam, we're going to have a 1-0 record for our motion here.
It does seem that way, doesn't it?
10.8 on the clock. 5-point lead.
And
get the ball in bounds.
J.
Janelle Jenkins at the top.
Yeah, they need to foul. Yeah, I don't know what they were thinking there, guys. Obviously, the move is to foul. You got to get them on the line. And Jenkins now, he's going to have an opportunity.
As you mentioned a little bit earlier, our next home game, mark your calendars, fans, if you're able to make it or not, but April 20th is going to be our next game right here at the Avenir Center. Our next home game, that is.
Yep.
So we've got 3.7 seconds left on the clock. Moncton's up 89-84. We're going to shoot a couple foul shots here, but that should be a wrap for Moncton's first win.
Yeah, absolutely. And this is, I can't think of a better way for our night to end here, Adam, with a win. And honestly, the motion played really well in this fourth quarter. This was a really entertaining, well-played fourth quarter. We had some sloppiness at times through the first three. You saw really the potential of this team and how clean this offense could look. And how exciting they're going to be defensively. 1-for-2 at the line, and here it is. A win in the first outing for the Moncton Motion. 1-0.
So what are we thinking for the player of the game, pal? We're gonna go offline and discuss this here, I believe.
Are we going to think about it? Are we going to sign off, and they're going to have to stick around and hear it on the live stream?
You tell me, brother. I'm going to grab the mic and go announce it. I'm going to sign off here, so thank you very much to the fans that tuned in. Over 1,000 strong, and that'll be myself. We'll see you next game.
Yeah, thanks, fans.
Short. If that's your team, they looking boring. We out here scoring. 20 point low out, y'all know the vibes. We handing L's out. Feel that motion. They double team me behind the back pass. My teammate is wide open. Throw that alley, you jump out the gym. Got the crowd hype, baseline dunk right off the spin.
Check, check, 1-2.
Yeah.
All right, Motion fans, it's time for our player of the game announcement, sponsored by MVP Barbershop. Our player of the game tonight, number 30, Janelle Jenkins. Make some noise. Get a couple words from Janelle here, if you don't mind. First of all, congratulations, man. What a game. You came out with all kinds of intensity. Damn, that's cold. I'll get it turned this way. We'll get a photo here. So congratulations on the player of the game. Lots of pace, lots of aggressiveness, both sides of the court. How are you feeling about your performance and getting the first win of the franchise here tonight?
Man, I feel really good, man. I'd like to shout out to the fans, everybody that came out, and we gave a good show for the fans. And just want them to have fun, you know. So I'm glad we got this W, and I appreciate everybody, man, and support. So,
congratulations, man. Nice to meet you. Give it up for Janelle Jenkins, our player of the game, sponsored by MVP Barbers. Go get your next cut down there on Main Street in Moncton. And we'll see you back here, fans, on April 20th for our next home game. Thank you so much to everybody for coming out and making the very first Moncton Motion game a huge success. Thank you, Moncton. We'll see you on April 20th.